My dear 8th standard students, welcome back for second term lesson, History Unit 5, Educational Development in India. In this module, we are going to discuss about the ancient system of education in India, development of education in medieval and modern period, importance of national educational policy, and development of education in Tamil Nadu. Let me move on to the video session.
History Unit 5, Educational Development in India. The world we live is constantly changing and developing. So to meet the challenges and overcome the obstacles, we need to be well educated and to know the role of the education in the human development process. Let us learn the development of education in India. Education is a continuous process of acquiring and sharing of knowledge, skills and values. Education is recognized as the foundation of a progressive society. It plays a vital role in shaping responsible people. Education in ancient India. The tradition of teaching and learning had been vogue in India. Vogue means fashion or style. The concept of education might have originated from the Vedas. The literal meaning, the Sanskrit word Veda, is knowledge, and the word derived from the word Vid, which means to know. It emphasized on values such as humility, truthfulness, discipline, self-reliance and respect for all creations. Sources of learning. The names of Panini, Aryabhatta, Katyayani and Patanjali, the writings and their medical treatises of Charaka and Shishruta were also some of the sources of learning. Various disciplines such as history, logic, interpretation, architecture, polity, agriculture, trade, commerce, animal husbandry and archery were taught. The gurus and their students worked consciously together to become a proficient in all aspects of learning. Ancient education system in India, a way of life. In ancient India, both formal and informal education existed. Temples played a vital role in imparting education and served the centers of learning. Teaching was oral, and students remembered and meditated upon what was taught in the gurukulas. During the early period, education was imparted by the teacher to the pupils who gathered around him and came to live in his house as members of his family. This was known as Gurukula system of education. Objectives of Gurukula system. During that period, the gurus and their shishyas lived together, helping each other in day-to-day life. The main objective was to have complete learning, leading a disciplined life, and realizing one's inner potential. Students lived away from their homes for years together till they achieved their goals. The Gurukula was also the place where the relationship between the guru and student strengthened with time. Viharas and universities under Buddhist period. Through monasteries and viharas, Buddhist scholars carried out the educational work. As a result, many famous educational centers came into existence. Among the most notable universities that emerged during that period were situated at Taxila, Nalanda, Vallabhi, Vikramashila, Ottantapuri and Jagadala. These universities developed in connection with the Viharas. Role of the teacher. Teachers had complete autonomy in all aspects, from selection of students to designing their syllabi. When the teacher was satisfied with the performance of the students, the course concluded. He would admit as many students as he liked and taught what his students were keen to learn. Debate and discussions were the primary methods of teaching. Teachers were assisted by their advanced level students. Education in medieval India. Medieval period witnessed a radical transformation and introduction of Muslim education in the Indian subcontinent. The country was invaded by various foreign rulers and several traders from different parts of the world. The tradesmen and the invaders brought with them their own cultures and intermingled with the people of the country. The aim of education during Muslim period was the elimination and extension of knowledge. The arrival of the Muslims. Muslim rulers promoted urban education by bestowing libraries and literary societies. They founded primary schools, call it as maktabs, in which students learn reading, writing and basic Islamic prayers, and secondary schools, madrasas, were established to teach advanced language skills. Several madrasas means secondary schools, were set up by the sultans and nobles. The main objective of these madrasas was to train and educate the scholars. Iltutmish was the first ruler to establish a madrasas at Delhi during his rule. Gradually, many madrasas came into existence. Madrasas means what? Secondary schools. System of education. The system of education in medieval India was under the control of ulama. Ulama means Islamic law. During those days, education was related to religious training. However, various subjects such as medicine, Arabic literature, grammar and philosophy were also taught. Women education in India was prevalent during the medieval period. Raja Jai Singh. Raja Jai Singh of Jaipur encouraged learning of scientific subjects. Besides, many institutions were started by private individuals. The British came to India and introduced English education. With the coming of the European missionaries, Western education made firm advances in the country. Various universities and thousands of colleges were formed and popularity of education increased. Modern system of education. The beginning of the modern system of Indian education can be traced to the efforts of the Christian missionaries who arrived in India in the wake of European occupation. As a result of their efforts, many institutions were established across India. This institution imparted Western as well as Indian education. Role of Christian missionaries. Europeans came to India for trade and established trading companies. The Europeans thought that they could make Indians understand the administration and religious theories better if they could impart education to the local population in their own method. So they started educational institutions. The Portuguese were the first Europeans who started modern system of education in India. Francis Xavier started a university at Cochin. They started many primary schools. The first college offering degrees on a completion of a course was started, where Christianity, logic, grammar and music were taught. Followed by the Portuguese, the French opened their institutions for all the Indians, where education was imparted by Indian teachers through local languages. They started higher secondary schools where French language was taught. Two German bishops started schools and a training college for teachers in Travancore. Missionaries made a good deal of attempt for the propagation of education in India. Due to their effort, many institutions were established. These institutions imparted Western education as well as Indian education. Education in the British rule. History of education in British rule can be divided into four periods. From the early days of the British rule up to 1813, period from 1813 to 1853, period from 1854 to 1920, and period from 1921 to till 1947. Let we go through under each heading. From the early days of the British rule up to 1813, during its early days, the East India Company followed a policy of indifference and non-interference towards education, as this sector did not form a part of its program. The company's charter was renewed in 1813, which compelled the company to assume responsibility for the education of Indians. Raja Ram Mohan Roy of Bengal, Pachyappar of Madras, W. Fraser of Delhi contributed to the cause of education. Period from 1813 to 1853. The second period was also marked by great educational controversies. First, there were the Orientalists, who supported the preservation of Oriental learning and the use of Sanskrit and Persian as the media of instruction. They were opposed by the Anglicists. Anglicist means expert in English, who advocated dissemination of Western knowledge through English. Dissemination means spreading information or knowledge. A third section believed in the use of Indian languages as the media of instruction. The controversies continued till 1854. Period from 1854 to 1920. The third phase of British influence education may be called the period of an All India Educational Policy. It commenced with Sir Charles Wood's dispatch in 1854. The Wood's dispatch 1854 is called the Magna Carta of English Education in India because it was the first declaration of British education policy for educating the masses at all levels. Masses means people. But it resulted in the complete control on state education, diverging it from Indian idols and culture. Period from 1921 to 1947. The new programs were hit hard by the worldwide economic depression in 1929, the introduction of complete provincial autonomy by the Government of India Act of 1935, further strengthened the position of the provincial ministers of education. After the Second World War, a very important plan for educational development known as the Surgeon Report 1944 was prepared. This blueprint had a powerful influence on contemporary education, both in thought as well as in practice. Educational development of independent India. The new period in the history of education was assured with the attainment of independence in 1947. It brought a new hope, a new vision, a new future for the Indians. In 1948, Dr. Radhakrishna Commission was appointed to present a report on university education. One of the most important events that have taken place in the field of secondary education was the appointment of Secondary Education Commission in 1952-53. It suggested new organizational patterns, improvement in quality of textbooks, curriculum and methods of teachings. Free and compulsory primary education for all children up to the age of 14 years and uniform educational structure of 10+2+3 pattern were its main recommendations. National Policy on Education. The first National Education Policy of 1968 marked a significant step in the history of education in post-independent India. It aimed to promote national progress, a sense of common citizenship and culture, and to strengthen national integration. In 1986, the Government of India introduced a new education policy. The new education policy called for a child-centered approach in primary education and launched Operation Blackboard to improve primary schools nationwide. The new education policy was revised again in 1992. It envisaged the formulation of national curriculum framework, emphasis on in-service education, improvement of facilities and streamlining of the evaluation system at the secondary stage. Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. The Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan SSA is the Government of India's flagship program that was launched in 2000 to 2001 to achieve Universal Elementary Education UEE. Right to Education RTE provides for free and compulsory education to all the children from the age 6 to 14 years. The SSA, that is Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, initiates a variety of innovation and activities related to school. Some important activities include providing the midday meals and stipends for students, the setting up of school management committees and provision of teaching learning materials for classrooms. Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan, RMSA, is a centrally sponsored scheme for universalization of access and improvement of quality education at the secondary stage. The goal of RMSA, that is Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan, is to make secondary education qualitatively available, accessible and affordable to all young students in the age group 15 to 16 years. Science lab, libraries, in-service training for teachers, computer-aided education, co-curricular activities and teaching learning aids are provided by the Government of India through RMSA scheme at the school level. Educational development in Tamil Nadu. The pattern of education in Tamil Nadu was not merely reading and understanding of books, but listening to learned persons. The Thirukkural stresses the need for education and warns the dangers of illiteracy. In ancient times, the school was called Palli and the teacher was a Kanakkayar. A significant development took place in the field of education during the Pallava period. The Pallava kings supported those educational institutions through endowments. The Vaishnava and Saiva mutts provided boarding and lodging facilities to all students and teachers. Yong Sang gives a graphic picture about Kanchi Buddhist center, and Kanchi was considered as the main center of learning. The Chola period. The Chola period was the most brilliant and creative period in the Tamil literature. Tamil education enjoyed a greater connection with religion and temple. Free education was given to people. The curriculum and syllabi had a theoretical background. From the inscription of that period, we can now gain knowledge about the qualification of teacher, method of teaching, salary of teachers, food provided to the students, and the land given to the schools, etc. Rajaraja Chaturvedi Mangalam was the famous seat of a Vedi college. Vedi college was flourished. The Pandya kings. Pandya kings patronized Sanskrit in an exemplary way. Exemplary means perfect way. It is revealed in the copper plates. The educational institution of that period were called as Gatigai, Salai and Vidya Sadhana. Lands were given to teachers. They were known as Salabogam. Many educational institutions were established under their patronage. Thinnapalli Kudam was established during the Nayak rule. Education in modern period. Fernandez, who came to Madurai during the time of Veerappa Nayak, established a primary school. The Maratha ruler Sarfoji II collected the old records and kept them in the Saraswati Mahal Library, Tanjore. He also had a printing press with Devanagari type located there. Sir Thomas Munro, the governor of Madras Presidency, was highly responsible for the introduction of Western education in Madras Presidency. He appointed a committee to conduct a statistical survey of the condition of education. In 1835, Lord William Bentinck passed a resolution favoring the introduction of Western system of education in India. The Madras University was founded in 1857. It was the first university in Tamil Nadu under the British rule. In 1882, the Local Boards Act was passed. The board was empowered to open new schools and to get grant from the government. By 1938, all subjects except English were taught in Tamil in schools. The Annamalai University was founded at Chidambaram in 1929. This was the next step in the development of higher education. Education since independence. Free education at the secondary school level was introduced in 1964-65. The Gandhigram Rural College was established in 1975. Distance education in 1971 has also been introduced in Tamil Nadu to educate those who could not go to colleges. In 1956, midday meal program was introduced in schools. Later, it was extended as nutritional meal in 1982 to avoid dropouts in schools. Since 1986, several changes have been taken place to meet the changing dynamics of the society in keeping with the national policy of education. Look at the map, children. This is India outline map. See north side, Taxila is given, Delhi is given, the right of Delhi is Lucknow, and the right of Lucknow is Vikramshila, and below Lucknow is Allahabad, and the right of Allahabad is Nalanda, and below Nalanda is Calcutta, now we call it as Kolkata, and the west side is Wallaby. Look at the south side, Madras is given, and the left of Madras is Kanji, and the below Kanji is Chidambaram, and the left of Chidambaram is Cochin. So children, go through the lesson and learn book back questions. Take care of yourself. Bye.